Hello there. We're back here with some more WWE World Wrestling Network, of course. We are on the final episode of our deal with YouTube, so we will be having our first show on our own broadcaster, which is, of course, WWE Live. That will be happening next month. And then we will debut a new title, which will be the WWE Live Championship. And will be pretty much a floating title, just really a way to showcase other talent from the other promotions in the alliance. Now, speaking of debuting new titles, we will be debuting a WWE Women's Championship. I'm looking forward to debuting that. That will be debuted next week, sorry, next month. And also, we will be debuting a new title tonight. Well, it's not really a new title, but it's new to us. And that is the Wrestle 1 Championship. Now, we have moved it down to be a mid-card title. And the reason for that is because, this is our main title. That's our world title, our main event title. So, the Wrestle 1 Championship will be a mid-card title. And I did acquire Wrestle 1. You can see here. We have any status. We've got all the titles. We haven't got them all active, but we've got them there. So if we ever want to use them, we can. Think about you. Oh, well, there's no player. Regardless, anyway. But that will be on the line tonight in a 3 or 4 way match. And we will choose the first WWE Wrestle 1 champion there tonight. Now, I haven't got anybody from the roster over. I didn't sign anybody on the contract just because I kind of like the size of the roster at the minute. And I will in the near future bring more people in, but I like where we are in terms of the roster size. Now, not only that, I can't open it up here. I could open. Yes. So we've got four. We have four events that we brought over from Wrestle 1. We have Wrestle 1 Outbreak, which will be in the week 4 of June. Wrestle 1 Anniversary, which will be in week 3 of September. Wrestle 1 Autumn Bout, which will be week 3 of November. Now, of course, this could all change, and we have Sunrise, which will be the first week of January. So, yeah, that's all we need to talk about there. And the reason why I bought Wrestle 1, I was like 218,000 or something, is just because we're starting to make more money. And I want them to build this up to become something big, and they've got our importance in Kanto now, and the whole of Japan has increased, I think, anyway. I'm pretty sure. But our importance definitely has increased big time in Kanto from buying that over, and our pop has also increased. Right, will it come up with the increase here? Oh, we've actually went down in some places. In terms of a pop, that's a shame. That's a shame. Japan. Okay, it's not gonna show the change there. But that's something that we're gonna have to think about fixing there and increasing that pop more, because I don't know why it would have went down. We're doing good shows. Maybe it's because we're doing so much shows, few and far between. So maybe it's now time to start to go, right, we've got the money, we've got the roster. Why don't we start to do more shows every few weeks, every 2 weeks or so? And even if we don't have everybody available for that show, then we can have a show every month where we showcase the lower half of the card, and a show every month where it's everybody in there, including people like Cody Rhodes, Rob Van Dam, Adam Cole, the main event team, stuff like that. But so yeah, we are wanting to make WWE big. We are wanting to become a powerhouse in the wrestling industry, and we are building a wrestling monopoly essentially, which will consist of buying out companies and also buying over companies to work as child companies, stuff like that. But let's go ahead and we'll go in here. And how much people? Not a lot of people expect to come out now. As we are losing pot, maybe it would be worth going to a different location. Well, we won't add you yet, but when we start doing two shows a month, we will go to different locations. So that's 20. Let's assign this venue, and we'll go ahead and we'll run that show. Now, although we are not going to sell like this venue for some reason, but you know, at least we can, at least we're still going into the ECW Arena, which is where all the big shows I think will be. And then what we'll do is we'll go when we do the smaller shows. Now, I haven't come up with a name yet for the smaller shows. But what we could do is we'll call it a different name, we'll do it monthly, and what we can do is for the smaller shows, what we can do is go to different regions in the country, stuff like that. Let's go ahead and run the show though, because it's like 5 minutes in, 6 minutes in even. So we start off the show here with if it would load up, I'm gonna get a drink while it's loading. Start off the show here with a 60-minute segment with Rob Van Dam. Rob Van Dam comes out and addresses. That's not bad actually, it's almost silly, it's pretty much 1200 people at Alex. But Rob Van Dam comes out and addresses the fact that Adam Cole attacked him and that Paul Heyman has said that Adam Cole may very well get a match for his championship if he defeats Matt Sydal tonight. And Rob Van Dam pretty much says that he made a big mistake attacking him, and if he does beat Matt Sydal, he would love Adam Cole to get a chance at his title, just so as it gives him a reason to go one-on-one with Adam Cole and teach him a lesson in respect, is the sort of gist of what we got here. It's a weird segment, not bad at all. Then we go into our next match here, where we see, sorry, our next segment here, where we go into the first match, where Cody Rhodes takes on Will Ospreay. No real reason behind this match, just like most of the matches on this card, really. But in a bout that had a great heat and decent wrestling, Cody Rhodes defeats Will Ospreay in 12 minutes by pinfall with a beautiful disaster. So Will Ospreay is involved in a really a high profile match going up against one of the top guys in the company, and although he doesn't get the win, it's definitely not going to harm him in the long run. 51 in-ring performance for Cody Rhodes and a 44 for Will Ospreay. 47 with it event overall though. Not bad. Now we go into our next segment here, where we have a match for the we have a superb match for the Wrestle1 Championship. Sonata takes on Ricochet, Colt Cabana, and Sami Callihan in 15 minutes. Sonata is the one who picks up the victory here after he lands a moonsault on Colt Cabana and gets the pinfall victory, and he becomes the first Wrestle1 champion in WWM. Ricochet carries the match, and Sonata is the weak link. But he's a weak link with a 47 rated in-ring performance, which is one of the better performers in our company. So that speaks volumes to me that he's the weak link, but with still a pretty high rated performance, really, for the level or for the size of our company. 59 for Colt Cabana, a 58 for Sami Callihan, but it's Ricochet who gets the highest rated in-ring performance here with a 72. Now, Colt Cabana is improving his technical skills. So why have I decided to give Sonata the championship? And that's simple. One, I want to push Sonata big time. I think he's going to be a star in this company. And also, with Wrestle1 being a Japanese promotion, Sonata being the only Japanese guy that we have, I thought, you know what, let's give him the title then, and we'll let him hold on to the title. 62 minute segment of all, not bad. Then we go on to our next segment here, where we see Sonata celebrating the ring with the championship. 32 minute segment, not bad, but not great. Tessa Blanchard goes up against Lufisto and Nikal Matthews, and of course Lufisto is involved in a storyline with Kelly Ray, remember, and in a decent match Lufisto defeats Tessa Blanchard and Nicole Matthews in 13 minutes, when Lufisto defeats Nicole Matthews by submission with Lufisto's lower 2 seconds. Apologize about that, I had a cough there. Have a very bad throat recently. The announcing quality lifts the match though. The colour commentary gives the match a boost. A 39 with the in-ring performance for Tessa Blanchard and a 44 for the Fisto. Nicole Matthews gets an in-ring performance of 41. So the Fisto wins this one. No interference from Kelly Ray or anything. For the 8 minute segment, but keep that in mind as straight away after the match ends, Kelly Ray runs into the ring, and of course the first day defeated Kelly Ray last month. So what we need now is we need a rubber match to determine the victor. Apologise for that again. But we need a rubber match, so that is what we're setting up to here. And Paul Heyman comes out and tells him to separate, and he says that they will finally settle their differences in next month in a singles match. That will be for the and it will be for the. What do you call it? I can't remember what I call it. Oh, it's WWN Women's. Oh, why the fuck? I'm so bad at this shit. it's for the WWN Women's Championship, the first ever WWN Women's Championship. And so we're gonna book that in there. So, really, not only is this a grudge match, but it's a title match too, and it's gonna be a big title match. What date is it, by the way? June. Yeah, we could do that in. Outback actually on week 4. That would be a big, a pretty big match there for Outback. So that's what we will do. Let's go ahead and take Kenny Ware and Lufisto, and they will finally settle the differences between each other, and it will be for the title as well. For the Outback segment, there, not bad. Then we move on to a triple threat match, really just to showcase some of the lower card. In a decent match, it's Chuck Taylor, who goes over against Jonathan Gresham and Tyrone Evans. In 10 minutes 44 seconds, when Chuck Taylor defeats Tyrone Evans by submission with a cross grab. Chuck Taylor carries the match in terms of in-ring performance with a 51 really in-ring performance. Not bad at all, pretty damn happy with that. Definitely somebody I will be looking to push in the mid card. 41 in ring performance there for Jonathan Gresham and 38 for Tyrone Evans. Not bad, not bad match at all. 46 with the segment overall. This next match is a number one contenders match. The winner of this match will go on to face Motorcycle Machine Guns at Outbreak in a decent match. The Hooligans are the ones that are victorious here, and they will go on to face Motorcycle Machine Guns after they defeat Mason Cutter and Matt Riddle. No, sorry, after Mason Cutter defeats Matt Riddle by submission in 30 minutes. 41 in ring performance there for Mason Cutter, 40 for Devon Cutter, 45 for Tracy Williams, and 36 for Matt Riddle. Tracy Williams is improving in his performance skills, right? Hopefully you we have everybody available for this show actually, because this seems to be already turning into a big show. So this is where we will have, well, we will probably debut the WWN Live Championship as well actually. Fully favorite segment, not bad. And we go on to our main event now, a 59-minute main event. Not bad, not great, but main event level, main event quality for promotion, let's face it. And a match that had a fantastic heat and good wrestling. We have Adam Cole go over here against Matt Sydal in 16 minutes 35 seconds by pinfall with a Panama Sunrise. And during the match, just before the end, Drew Galloway comes out and distracts Sydal. 68 minute in performance there for Adam Cole and a 50 for Matt Sydal. Now, where's this storyline going? With Matt Sydal and Drew Galloway in a 59-minute segment, we go to the next segment and we will find out. Which, by the way, actually, before I do that, the main event of Outbreak is going to be a one-on-one match between Adam Cole and Rob Van Dam there, which really seems like it's being pushed to the back burner, but that's fine. We know it's established, but we need to establish this now, so it's more important to establish this one than establish something that's been pre-established. Drew Galloway, is kind of he's about to attack Matt Sydal when Brock Lesnar comes down. Paul Heyman's enforcer comes down to break it up, but Drew Galloway gets out there straight away. Paul Heyman then comes out and says that Drew Galloway and Matt Sydal better work out their differences for within the next 2 weeks, as they will both be teaming up to go up against Paul Heyman's enforcer, Paul Heyman's beast, Brock Lesnar. So that is going to be a big match on that card at Outbreak. So it will be a 2-on-1 handicap match. There are handicap matches in this, right? Two on one, yep. So it will be a 2-on-1 handicap match. Drew Galloway and Matt Sydal, the rivals, will go up against Brock Lesnar. So I thought that would be an interesting turn in this story. Something a little bit different here. You have the sort of feared enforcer character taking on both Drew Galloway and Matt Sydal, and I have an idea here where it will pull along the storyline between these two, and it won't make them seem weak whenever Brock Lesnar inevitably goes over, because of course he's going to go over. It's Brock Lesnar. We're not going to have him lose his first match. Like, come on. 65 minute segment, not bad to end the show. 58 minute show overall. Tywin Evans was slightly overused though, and the show increases the popularity in 45 regions. I'm happy with that. Make a speech. Adam Cole done very well on this show. Thanks for a great performance. Colt Cabana took the loss, so I definitely need to point him out as a good example. And how about we go for who was a standout performer then? Ricochet was a standout performer. Got a very high rated performance, so we will praise him. Make that speech. Adam Cole seems pleased, as did Colt Cabana and Mike. Oh shit, I selected the wrong person. Off. Well, you know what? Refs don't get enough credit. Just give them a wee bit of credit. I'm going to accept that. My friend just messaged me. So there will be a couple matches put in there for our next show, which is of course Outbreak, Wrestle 1 Outbreak. And they'll just kind of be exhibition matches, but the card there itself I think is pretty strong. We have a good storyline going on between Matt Sydal and Drew Galloway. We have a good storyline between LeFestu and Kaylee Ray. Maybe not a strong storyline between Adam Cole and Rob Van Dam, but that doesn't matter because we're going to get an excellent match out of it regardless. I have to say, Oh, and then we also have the tag team champs, which isn't really a storyline at this point, it's just kind of there. Which is a shame, but it is what it is. Sonata will be putting his title on the line, but it will be. I'm not sure how I'll decide who's gonna go up against him for that. I think it'll be kind of a deal of. It'll kind of be the deal of. We'll do a match at the start of the event, and then there you go, you have your two matches in there extra, and every match means something. There's a reason to each match. We finished our broadcasting deal with YouTube Premium, so now we're going to our pay-per-view service, which is our own broadcasting company. And schedule. So let's see, yeah, we have Tuesdays available. So every show will have to be on a Tuesday, which is fine. Something else that we will do is we will add in a new event after we get this show over and done with. WrestleOne Outbreak, and then it'll probably be monthly, so we'll have two shows running a month. We'll have WWE and Live, and we'll have something else. Alliance, yeah, so that's good there. We will want to put in an alliance tail at some point. So we don't have child companies yet, but we will soon enough. So I'm thinking of buying over another company as well. You know, we have 14, we have 1.4 million. We start off with 1 million, so. Doing well in terms of that, and we are wanting to go after as many companies as possible. We are wanting to build a monopoly here, and as long as I have the money to buy them over, why not buy them over? You know, that is where our investments are going to be best served. I'm thinking of going with Stardom and all. Isn't it all female? Yes, it is an all-female company, and then we can have a network title, an alliance title then. If we, oh yes, they did. That's not bad. That's not bad. Now I'm not sure if we can do this, but I'm gonna try it anyway, and I'm gonna see if I can take a, if I can still take some of the assets. But I'm gonna see if I can still take some of the assets and make them to film, and I'm not sure if I can or not. So we'll go with, say. Stardom X Stardom. Stardom Fist of the World might be a good one actually as well. And Stardom Golden Mare. Now you know what, we'll just go with those two. And we'll just take a random title, see if we can do it. The film and all. But you, so it's like 129,000, which is a lot of money, but you know, I'm more than happy to pay that because we have the money there, and we are building a. Okay, no, we didn't take any of the assets, which is fine. I'm happy enough with doing that, but it's an experiment, and now we have a child company under our comp with us. So let's get view on broadcaster. So how do I put their products onto my broadcaster then? Nope. Oh wait, is this for Stardom? It must be. New deal for events. Yes it is. So we'll give them prime time. Get as much people watching as possible. And unlimited. Yep, let's make them that deal. There we go. Now we have a child company under our belts. And now we have all these. We have another company under our belts, and does that automatically put them into the alliance? No, it doesn't. So we're gonna have to put a company, put Stardom into that alliance. Ooh. World Wonder Ringstorm. Yes. Okay, it's now a member of the Alliance. So now we have two companies in there, which is women's oriented. We can do maybe a women's title belt. So that will be the first title that we put in there. Well, what should we call it though? Will it just be the Network Women's Championship? World Wrestling Network is the name of the alliance. You know what, let's just call it the Network Women's Championship. Now, if you do have any better names for it, it might take a while because I do like to record a few episodes at a time. Let me know, and we will get that changed. World of Stardom, you know what, we're just gonna, actually I don't like that one. We should take Shines. Shines is nice. Let's go just take Shines, sure. Next title belt. Singles, female only. Foot ring. And by the time then we get round to our next show, it might already be taken, but if not, we will probably put in a match in there for it. Yeah, that seems decent enough for me. So now we need to go into our team booking, and for Upek we will book another match, and it will be a four-way match, and it will be between, not have any main event, isn't it? Let's have a way that we can showcase our lower mid card. Our mid card, and we can still have some. Okay, Shock Taylor. This is going to be the putting Tracy Williams in there. This will be the number one contenders match for the. Oh shit! For the Wrestle One Championship. Wrestle One contenders match, and the winner of that will go on and face Sonata at the same event. So this will probably open the show, and then Sonata will take on the winner. So that's, we'll have six matches in there, and they all mean something. They all have a meaning for being there. They're not just slot in. Cody Rhodes isn't in there though, which is a shame, but whatever. We might put him into a play show or something. But yeah, oh, Simon Callahan has been malicious. Good bonus. Because, oh, shit. He was upset at the booking, I believe. Okay, but he's not going to take that bonus. You're annoyed, we'll give you a bit of money. Are you being serious, mate? Yeah, take. There we go. You are absolutely fuming, aren't you? So we're gonna have to give you more money. Oh, fucking hell. But you know what, we have the money to do this. We have a lot of money. We're gonna make more money. We're gonna become a huge company in the world of professional wrestling, and the way I see it is dealing with Morales is just really it's just an investment in the future of our company. So thank you very much for watching this one, and yeah, that'll be it. See you again. Goodbye.